Hey everyone, welcome to a very special over beer reaction discussion. My name is Rich, and let me switch to my co-host.
So stupid. My name is Nick.
So we're talking about the Nintendo Switch big reveal.
The big reveal, and also the information that has come out after.
So basically all the information
we're recording this like a week late.
Yeah, we're recording this
about
a week late. You guys are watching this right after we record it. So it's all the information up until the 18th that we have.
I think that it's going to be more of a reaction to the information than going over the information. Like, sure. The information's been out there. I don't know if we need to go line by line.
We'll talk a lot
about a lot of it. But one thing that, you know, and we'll see as this goes on, we haven't actually talked that much about how we felt about it.
No, we've kind of saved it for...
But one thing that I think might switch is your typically grouchy demeanor versus my not always grouchy. Mm-hmm. I think that might switch a little bit. Just from some tweets that I've seen from you and stuff like that.
Sure.
So, where shall we begin?
Why don't we start at release and price point?
Back in 1984, Nintendo was a burgeoning company.
What did you think? What squid you think about the the price point? So, the price is $299.99 US, releasing on March 3rd.
I think that with a lot of the information that we got with the Switch, price included, it is all on the absolute fringe of acceptability.
I would agree.
So the price point is $299 with tax. It's over $300. I think the price is a mistake.
Really?
I think, here's the thing, is it a fair price? Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But when all of the signs and rumors for months had pointed to as low as $200 and commonly $250, to then make it $300 without a game in the box.
See, all the rumors I had seen were pointing to $250 or $300, but a lot of those rumors did include a pack-in game.
I think that makes it disappointing. And then, you know, when you see that routinely you can get PS4s and Xbox Ones cheaper mm-hmm. than what the Switch will be, and those are still superior systems, we assume, because Nintendo didn't divulge any information on any...
Like the tech, like tech. The specific chips or any of that kind of stuff.
Superior with, certainly at this stage, far superior libraries of games.
Mm-hmm.
It's not great, and it leads me to believe that, like the 3DS having the $70 price drop within its first year.
This gives it the wiggle room to price drop if need be.
But that sucks for if you want to buy it at launch.
Sure.
I think that for what you're getting at launch and what we assume we're getting in the first 6 months, it seems a little steep. Just a little. I think that without the game in there, I think that this should have been $250. And honestly... But I don't think it's egregious. $300 is still not much.
Yeah, I mean, as somebody who paid $350 for the Wii U at launch,
right?
I'm okay with the $300.
But on top of that, I think that the price point of some of the other stuff around it is outrageous.
I mostly agree.
Almost doomsday level outrageous.
I agree.
Do you have any of that written down?
Yes, I do. I have all that written down. Pro controller is $70.
That's... See, absurd.
I don't think that's
crazy.
If you go and you were to go buy a PS4 controller and it's $65.
Okay, but almost $5 difference. Always $50 you can get those things.
Sure, but I'm saying like the suggested retail price of it's a $5 difference. I don't think the Pro Controller is too outrageous. That is the one price I am okay with.
It's too high.
Where I get
70 sounds dumb.
Where I get
stupid.
Worried and irked are the price of the Joy-Cons,
which are.
So you can buy a right or a left Joy-Con on their own for $50. Or you can buy the set for $80.
Crazy.
And that's nuts.
That's ludicrous.
Now, and again, like, I'm not defending these prices or anything, but a big part of that price, from what I have seen and read, has to do with the fact that there is a lot of tech in these Joy-Cons. A lot of tech that you and I don't really care about.
No.
Like... And I think the idea of the HD rumble is cool. I don't really care about it, though.
I don't care.
And then the dock on its own is $90.
Which the dock is something that you presumably don't have to rebuy. Like, sure. Why do you need to buy
it? The only reason you need to buy a dock is if, like, you wanted to hook it up to multiple TVs in your home.
But see, that's the thing.
Or take it to your significant other's house or somewhere.
That item is like a luxury item.
Yes. But so is an extra controller.
Not really.
When it comes with two controllers out of the box, it is.
It is and it isn't. Not for families that have, you know, three or four kids. Not for, you know, those are expectations that you'll have friends over and something that Nintendo wants. Another dock, just like another gamepad when Wii U, when it couldn't support two,
yeah,
that was a luxury. That it was something that they didn't even sell because they didn't want confusion, but you could get it through Nintendo. It was expensive. The Pro Controller outrageous to me. It just is. 70, it's too much.
I think it's a little high, but I'm not, like, outraged by it. I was like, okay, like, it's $5 more than, like, because I bought a second PS4 controller. It was $65. So for a Pro Controller for 70, I don't love it, but I'm not, like, up in arms about it.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of it. So let's talk about what... I know that going into that day and the months leading up to whenever we were finally going to learn about what the Switch really was, the one thing... All that mattered to me was games. Yep. Games, 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 games. That's all that mattered. I just wanted... I felt... You know, increasingly, and it's something that's well documented to people who watch the show, I felt increasingly more and more burned with Nintendo, with the Wii U, even though it had some good stuff there. It was overall a system that they abandoned for, I guess, good reason, but as somebody who bought it, especially the last like year and a half, 2 years of being a Wii U owner, it was just pointless.
Yeah.
In a lot of ways. And so it was just, give me the games. You haven't been working on Wii U games. You haven't been giving me anything to buy for the most part. And every sign pointed to the reason for that was because what probably would have been a Wii U was becoming a Switch game. And then what we got was nothing, almost. Basically nothing.
See, I'm okay. All right. I have here, this is, I guess, something that Nintendo put on their social media. It breaks down when games are coming out. Like, what they've announced through... the day of the conference, not including the Fire Emblem stuff that was just announced today, which maybe we'll bring up a little bit towards the end. So launch day, according to this, Breath of the Wild.
Okay, great.
1-2 Switch. Which...
1-2 Switch is something that you will play once.
That's a Wii Sports Nintendo Land game. That's a, let's try this. Like, I don't really care about it. So many
people instantly... I thought that it did look like a fun party game. Yes. I think that is a fun party game that you will play at a party.
It is once. A party game I will play at somebody else's party. I won't purchase it.
And the other thing with that game is, while it does look very fun, people instantly said the second that they showed that video, a million copycat developers just started making that for iPhone, and it will be 1/6 of the cost.
Sure.
Like...
So we have Super Bomberman R.
Yeah.
Which I am very excited. I'll get into that a little bit.
We'll see how, you know, we'll see how, we didn't see enough to get any sort of a take of that game.
I mean, there was a bunch of stuff on the next day in the treehouse.
Right. I know, but I, you know, sure.
Skylanders Imaginators. Cool. Just don't care. That's not a game for either of us. There are a lot of people who like it. Just Dance 2017. Again, not for us. People love it. Now that's launch day, March. Snipper Clips, which I think looks like a lot of fun.
I don't care. I watch it. That's the thing where you cut in paper and yeah. I'm all set.
Has-Been Heroes. I don't really know anything about this game, but I think it's also coming to PS4, Xbox One, or already is. I don't know. And then Fast something. Ah, shit.
No, but you see, but here's part of the problem. You already talked about the launch titles.
But
that's awful.
Is it?
Yes. It's awful.
What more do you need? See?
They should. Nintendo, you're dumb for not canceling the Wii U version of Zelda. That should be an exclusive. They are so stupid. This system should you shouldn't have the option to play it on but the other. You really shouldn't. You really should not.
And this is what I have been saying since the beginning. I know this. We've kind of disagreed on this for a long time. I don't think you can cancel the Wii U version.
Why?
Because you've promised it for so long. Who cares? But they aren't talking about it. They haven't said a word about it.
But if you still have so many people.
If you are the average consumer who does not know, who's like just waiting for it, and you see, oh, it's coming to Switch, well, I'll get the new console. Unless you're in the know, you aren't really still waiting for this on Wii U.
If you have a Wii U, you know, you've known that this game is coming. The small install base of that system knows. But I really think the amount of people, and this is why they're dumb. They're not dumb because people are still going to, the people who bought a Wii U and care about Zelda are going to get the Switch and going to get it on Switch. That's not my point. My point is this. The amount of people that I've heard, both outspoken in the gamer community and just people at work that I've talked to that are nowhere near as vocal as those people that have been like, there's not enough. I'm going to wait until at least the holidays because it's going to go down because Nintendo always has a drop and that's when Mario comes out and I will just get that game for now on my Wii U. They can't have a bad first 6 months of this system, and that would force it to have a better 6 months because people are not saying they're not going to get a Switch. They're saying I'm going to get a Switch later when there's more stuff.
Sure.
And that's the mistake. If this thing, thing starts off soft, and I don't mean it's going to start off, it's going to be impossible to find because that's what Nintendo does and it drives stories, but I mean truly sell well.
But it's that's what everybody says.
You've already screwed Wii U owners over for 2 years. You might as well have just not put it out on that. Like, we're used to being screwed over as Wii U owners. You're not causing any more bad. Can you really cause bad? No, you can't.
Because you have, maybe people can't afford the Switch at launch, and you're then causing the whatever little bit of a hardcore fan base you have left. They may not everybody can afford the Switch right now. I know, shrug, whatever, their problem.
But that's not what I even mean. Like, if you...
Like, I don't think you can burn them. They are your hardcore audience who will eventually jump to Switch. And if you burn them on this, they may go, well, fuck you, Nintendo. I'm not going to go get a Switch then. You've promised this to me for 3 years or however long, and now you're telling you're not going to give it to me. Then I'm done.
But I think also the weak or light, however you want to phrase it, launch titles... of this system and the low install base of the Wii U, what you might do is have a lot of people go, I don't have a Wii U. I'm not going to get the Switch yet. I'll get Breath of the Wild. You know, I'll buy this in the holiday season and I'll get Breath of the Wild then. And then by the time it comes out, a million other things come out. They get Mario for Christmas. They get the Switch. They can't afford Breath of the Wild. You might just be hurting Breath of the Wild sales, period, by doing this.
Or because it is available everywhere, it's going to help. Who knows? I don't know.
But that is the only game at launch that truly matters.
I am okay with this launch lineup. Something
that I already have. The launch lineup sucks.
How? Because here's my thing. Okay, we've got Zelda, Breath of the Wild, the one game we've all been waiting for.
But you could get it. But I can get it for my Wii U, which I already own.
And for me, I have Zelda and I have Bomberman. I'm set. Like, Zelda's going to take me hours to play. I adore Bomberman. I miss the old school Bomberman games. I am ready to jump back into this. Like,
it better be good. If Bomberman is no good, then you have an issue.
Sure. Everything I've seen about it looks great. Looks like it's exactly what but Bomberman needs to be.
I hope so. But I'm just saying, if it's a middling game, then you're stuck with just Zelda, which you could have just bought on the other thing. And then all of a sudden, 7 months later, you have a price drop because that's what they're going to do. And then you're going to feel like, well, what did I do? Because in between, you have a Splatoon sequel that's not really a Splatoon sequel.
Well, see, I think...
And, like, who cares? Like,
okay. There's a lot of people that care.
I know. No, a lot of people care. I'm talking about us. Like, I know that you got Splatoon. How often did you play it?
A decent amount at launch. I haven't played it much since. But, okay, so let's... You want to go through the rest of this...
Sure.
This breakdown? Okay. So April 28th, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe.
Okay, I'm excited for that, but it's a game that I already have.
I'm just running through.
I know. I'm giving my opinions on these.
You don't gotta get mad at me.
It's infiltrated. This list is infiltrated with things that you've already played.
Sure. I'm definitely interested in Mario Kart 8 Deluxe.
Of course I'm gonna get it.
I'll get it. Spring 2017. ARMS.
That looks awful.
I think it looks kind of cool.
I think that looks awful.
You can play it with controllers without having to use the Joy-Con. I don't want to play it
anyway.
I think it looks
stupid.
I think it looks actually kind of cool. Disgaea 5. I don't really know anything about that series. You can get it on the other consoles. Puyo Puyo Tetris. Don't know too much about Rhyme. That was that one that PlayStation like took their dev kits away, and then they just recently re-announced the game for like all consoles or something. Summer 2017, Splatoon 2, which, cool. I won't get it at launch unless it has a new single player campaign or something for it.
They would have said that day. I think this is, if at best it's Splatoon 1.5. I think that to call it 2 is a bit deceiving.
Autumn 2017, Elder Scrolls 5 Skyrim.
Not HD.
Nope. Yeah, that's the really interesting thing about that one. It's like, it's not the remaster, it's not HD, it's not the special edition, it's Skyrim. Mm. So it's probably going to be somewhere between 360 Skyrim and current gen Skyrim. Skyrim on the go is still cool.
Skyrim. Well, let's talk, shelve the on the go thing.
Okay.
We'll talk about the on the
go. Holiday 2017, Super Mario Odyssey.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Well, let's talk about Mario for a minute. I think that everything in Mario looked really, really cool except for the city stuff.
I agree. And that might be fun. I think the city platforming stuff looks fun. I don't like seeing him next to real people.
I think that it feels very Sonic Adventure. Style. Yeah, that's another thing.
That was my first thought when he was like walking with people. I'm like, I'm back in Station Square in Sonic Adventure. Like, this just doesn't.
I don't like the look of that, and it could be a very fun level, and we don't know anything about this game yet.
But everything else about it looks really cool.
It looks good. Yeah.
And then 2017, ambiguous 2017. We have Xenoblade Chronicles 2, which I haven't played the other ones. I don't think you have, but it's a big deal for a lot of people. Minecraft. That's a big get.
It is, but it isn't. Right.
FIFA,
nothing.
Random FIFA, yeah.
Which there's some speculation that it's a port of last year's model, and there'd already be a new one
out. No, they did confirm that the new NBA 2K is going to be NBA 2K18, which is pretty,
that's cool.
Which is good. Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2, I already have it. Siberia 3, I don't know what that is. Ultra Street Fighter 2, the final challengers. Cool.
It'll be fun to play. It's a game that I played when San Francisco was in the Super Bowl in like 1993.
Sonic Mania. Cool. I've already pre-ordered it for PS4.
I thought about potentially if the collector's edition goes up.
It is up.
Well, it's unavailable on Amazon.
Oh, is it? Okay.
But I might switch my pre-order to the Switch just to have another game to play on it.
I Am Setsuna, which is already out on PS4. Steep, which is already out. And then Sonic, whatever the 2017 Sonic game is coming to it, as well as they just announced today in the Direct, Fire Emblem, whatever the new Fire Emblem game is going to be in 2018. So those are the games that we have so far. This is what they have announced.
I know. And E3 could change that.
E3 could change that. There could be, we suddenly yesterday said, oh, we got a Fire Emblem Direct coming up tomorrow. Get ready. So who knows what else is in the pipe? Again,
I mean, they also said that during the presentation.
There's like 80 games.
Well, no, I mean, they said during the presentation there'll be a Fire Emblem Direct later this week. Mm. But I just feel like the rampant speculation was we hadn't been getting stuff on the Wii U because everything was getting pushed to this, and it was just like, no, you guys have basically no first party stuff to show us. You have a Mario game that is, I don't even believe, is far enough along that it will actually come out at the end of this year.
But they've been developing that for, when did Super Mario 3D World come out?
They couldn't let anyone play anything, any part of that game. They couldn't, it wasn't far enough.
Because they don't want to focus on that.
Focus on what? Like, it's not like we were there.
No, I'm
talking about the press that they had invited.
Sure,
there.
Because they want the buzz to. They don't want the buzz from the way I see it. Is you don't want. You've already got people saying, "Well, I'm going to wait until 20 to the holiday to buy it for Mario. You don't want your buzz to be, hey, we've got this game coming out in March. Look at this great game we coming out, have coming out in 6-7 Mario months. Look at the great games we've got coming out.
Mario's going to get pushed. And they're going to fill the gap with the at E3 they're going to announce maybe something that's cool, probably just the Smash Brothers port.
Somewhere in here we still going to have Smash Brothers. Potentially we still have Pokemon Stars or whatever that's being called coming out for it. And if you have to assume there's still a rare announcement coming, or I'm sorry, retro announcement coming. Yeah. And then there was a quote because somebody was asking about Metroid and Mother 3, and there was like this very like ominous quote from Reggie about, hey, we're listening, just stay tuned. So,
but just show they
that's not and, Nintendo, but I'm not saying it's good or bad, I'm saying that's Nintendo.
No.
And we all.
But it doesn't need to be Nintendo anymore. And that's what's gotten Nintendo to this point where they're literally on the verge of, I don't know what would happen to them if this thing doesn't.
We've all been speculating and rumors and building up expectations of what this can be. And it's still the same Nintendo that it's always been.
It was a boring and bad buzz driven conference.
Oh, I agree.
And that is not what they need.
I am excited about the Switch. I agree that the conference was not good. And I think part of that was in fault of the translators.
Well, it seems like it wasn't really that guy's fault, right? Like, it seems like that guy didn't say what he was supposed to say.
I don't know what this... I can't speak Japanese. I don't know what this... Well, they haven't really said what the story is, but even when he was talking, he was just like... Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no, I think because he was like... I think he was thrown off. Was like, and then... immediately knew that he was sounding dumb because he was thrown off, and it only got worse from there. I don't know, but that didn't ruin it because no matter what he had said there, it couldn't have saved that moment of that. But because
I love the beginning of this where they're going through and they're saying, in the NES we had this, you came with two controllers, and the kind of like going through their heritage and seeing how that all got built into the Switch. And the more you look at the Switch and the more you see what it does, like, it really is sort of a culmination of everything in their history.
No, yeah, for sure it is.
And we still are getting virtual console games. Assume we're going to get virtual console games.
Well, let's talk about some of the other things that we know that we're getting. Because we know that we're going to get, with the new online service, we're going to get a free game once a month. Like you do with PlayStation Plus or Xbox.
Except Gold. You only have to keep it
you
for that
get
month.
It for a month.
You're getting either NES game or an SNES.
What?
Now hold on. What? So for there, it's going to be free, a free trial at the start, and then the holiday or the fall, they're supposed to start charging for it.
Because at least until the summer when Splatoon comes out, they have nothing for you to actually pay to use it.
And you're supposed to get a free NES or SNES game for the month, only for the month. I think you're supposed to get eShop deals with it, and then the SNES game will have online functionality.
Whatever that means.
Which is cool.
Whatever that means, though.
Sure. But if you get other, you know, old SNES games and you can play with friends and stuff, that's really cool.
But for a month, how frequently do you get to the free game of the month on PlayStation that month?
Sure. A couple things that we don't know how much it's going to be. That will be a big factor in how I feel about this.
I'm sure it'll be comparable. I mean, both Gold and Plus are 60 right now for the year.
And I could see them. I could see them doing something like, because what most virtual console games are like, what, $5, roughly for like an SNES or an NES game.
Probably.
So let's say it ends up costing you $30 for the $30 or $40. Let's say $40 for the year, and you get a game for a month. Blah 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 blah. You get eShop deals. You get this. They haven't said what happens at the end of that. You lose the game, yes, and they're like, oh, well, you can buy it. Do you get a discount? Like, hey, you've played the game for a month. Since you're a online subscription member, you can get it for 99 cents. Okay, I'm and then by the end of the year, I'm still paying what is comparable to if I were to buy a virtual console game a month.
Yeah, I mean, I could totally see them, that game, you know, for a 2-week period after is on discount or something like that. But
or you make
just,
or you
it
or you
just
tie
sounds
them...
it sounds awful.
It does.
It sounds awful when you know PlayStation can give you, you know, Rocket League and this and that, and Xbox is giving you Tomb Raider and et cetera, and it's just like, no, but we can't give you for free this game from 1985.
It sounds awful right off the bat, but I don't... In the same way, we jump to a lot of conclusions based on speculation going into this. I don't want to jump to conclusions based on lack of information. Again.
It just sounds bad. It's just, it continues the narrative of things just not sounding quite
right. Of them just not quite getting it.
No, they, yeah, exactly. They didn't get what they needed to do here. Another thing that I wasn't aware of until yesterday when you tweeted it was that at least at the start, the Switch will not be able to play multimedia things like Netflix, Hulu, yeah. Amazon Video.
As soon as I found out, that's when I tweeted about it. That just came out last night.
And it's just like, are you dense? Like, what are you, like, that... okay, but here's the thing. Yes, we all have things that can play that stuff. My cable box can play that
stuff. I'm not disagreeing that that's weird and dumb.
But it's just so... Okay, it continues what I was saying earlier, where you can routinely get these other systems that do give you the free game that you get to keep, and do give you the different options to play these things, and do let you play Blu-rays, and do let you do. I think
this falls into this is a gaming. They want this to be seen as a gaming console, not an all-in-one box. Because that was their pitch for the Wii U.
Yeah.
This is the center of your living room. This is the universe. And it failed.
But here's... And all of my issues with this... I'm getting the Switch. All of my issues stem from my extreme worry as a lifelong Nintendo fan.
That this is going to be...
this is going to doom Nintendo.
Sure.
And, like, you think of all the people who, you know, who haven't... Adults who haven't gotten a console in this generation yet. Or kids who are becoming... you know, 15, 16 year olds who can get a job and are like, now I can afford to get a console. I've still been rocking my 360 and might have been like, you know what? I could have got the Switch, but you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to wait a year now to get the Switch because there's not enough games and these systems are going to be cheaper and they have more games and they have more exciting games on the horizon, quite frankly.
No pun intended.
Kind of.
Which that's another issue I have right now.
If enough people say I'm going to wait 6 months or 12 months to get this thing, then it will be a failure and the third parties will run. I feel
like they have to know this. Like
they though? Like they didn't do anything about it with the Wii U.
But I feel like they have to know going into this. This is a kind of an awkward time. This is an unconventional time for a console launch. We're giving our big flagship title is the same game you can get on your old console. Like, I feel like they, you know, and they've, what, like 2 million units, I think, were what they're estimating or what they're aiming for, kind of right out the gate, is what they've said. Does that sound right?
I haven't heard
enough. I thought there was some kind of number that they had thrown out like that. I feel like they have to expect sales to maybe, and part of that is if they are really controlling, you know.
But they're a publicly traded company. I don't care what they're expecting. At the end of the day, it matters what your investors are expecting. Sure. And with a new console launch following one of the least successful consoles in history, you can't just...
I almost worry if they should have waited until the fall to launch this.
100%.
But then you also run into the issue... You run into the issue then of having too many games at once. And then stuff falls to the wayside.
I don't think it should. I think it should have been summer.
Okay.
Kids are off school. Kids have time to play. And then...
Like maybe even like then, a May. Like a May release.
Because it sounds like by May, maybe you get ARMS done. You have Mario Kart ready to go. And you make them just hurry up a bit with Splatoon 2. You got that. But it still would have felt like, okay, there's a lot of games here that we just played on Wii U. But it would have had more ironed out.
Or come out at the conference with a much more... And again, you know, in today's age, it's hard to put hard dates on things unless you're sure you're going to hit them. So you don't really want to map out something... And
Mario
something.
Will not hit that date. I'm telling you right now.
We'll see.
It won't. It's going to get pushed.
I hope not. Then they got right now they got nothing else for fall. If this is all they've...
They'll be Smash Brothers. With one extra character and a couple costumes.
And I'll buy it.
Of course I'll buy it too.
I'm See, then are we part of the problem then? We're sitting here complaining, why are you doing this? And we're... Are you... Okay.
No.
Are you getting
it
day one?
I think it would be a crime to not release those games on the system when nobody bought Wii U.
Yeah.
Like, those are games that need to... That those... The people who made those games deserve to have as many people play them as they can. Mm-hmm. But what am I going to get?
Are you getting it day one?
Unsure.
Okay.
There's talk of people getting this as a gift for me. It's right around my wedding. So if that happens, I'm not pre-ordering it because there's discussion of that, and we'll see if it comes to fruition.
Gotcha.
Yeah. I'm gonna buy like Breath of the Wild. If I can get my hands on the collector's edition, then I'm going to pre-order it and just have that for whenever I get a Switch.
Mm-hmm. That looks so nice.
Yeah, have you been able to lock one down?
Yeah.
Thanks for letting me know.
It was like 4 a.m.
Dick.
And they were like gone.
Oh, I know.
Like that.
Like every, and it's just
like a Switch.
And I always forget and how frustrating Nintendo is with how awful they are with stock of everything.
Well, and like the
just everything, they're the worst.
The launch happened, or the not launch, the conference happened, or press release, whatever the hell you want to call it, the press conference. And I was up until 4 o'clock in the morning just like watching pre-orders. I managed to get Switch pre-ordered from like 2 different places. Just in case something gets canceled, I don't want any problems or any issues. And then I just sat on Amazon's page and Best Buy's page for Breath of the Wild and was like, refresh, checking the tweets, checking everything. It was like 3 o'clock in the morning that like they went up.
Good. But they're so ridiculous with so much of that stuff. And honestly, if it is impossible to find for the average person when it comes out,
mm-hmm.
then there will be a lot of people that get frustrated with that and just say, you know what, I will just wait for the holidays.
Sure.
And that's going to screw them over even more. Like they and you just can see that happening because it's coming out so soon.
But I also wonder if like an issue with the stock is the hardcore of the hardcore, people who've been through the Amiibo problems, been through the NES Classic problems, did pre-order it like me multiple places. Like I've already heard other people was like, oh yeah, I pre-ordered like 2 different places. Like that can't help the stock of it either.
No, for sure. Yeah,
it's like because we've been burned before and we're like, well, I want to make sure, so stuff's gonna open up. I'm not buying 2 Switches.
Are you?
No, you're not getting that wedding present from me. I calculated how much I'm spending on launch day. It's not pretty.
Yeah. Any other?
Yeah, there's one other thing. Voice chat.
Oh yeah, that sounds stupid. With the app.
It does and it doesn't. Okay, so because there was the, if you guys don't know, there is no voice chat currently through the console itself. It's all going to be done through an app on your phone.
I have another thing to talk about, the portableness.
Oh yeah, we'll talk about the portable versus handheld stuff, or the home console versus handheld. The app on your, it's going to be an app on your phone, and that's how you're going to communicate with friends, players.
You know what else is on your phone that you can communicate?
Your phone. Sure. But the way, and I agree that it should launch with this. It should have it on the right from the, I imagine by Splatoon, they'll have it integrated in the console. You would hope. But Reggie came out and made a statement saying, you're on the go, you don't want to bring a big headset or a gaming thing with you, you already have your phone on you.
Where the hell are you playing online on the go?
It's anywhere you connect to Wi-Fi. Planes have Wi-Fi. Okay. I know, but I mean,
I don't think planes have Wi-Fi that's good enough for you to play online gaming, regardless.
That was...
Not yet.
Of like, oh, yeah, it's more...
No way. And that makes, just on a plane that had the worst Wi-Fi.
And that, to me, makes sense. Of like, that's one extra thing to carry around. It's, you already have your phone. That works. That makes sense. But
I guess.
It is weird. It's okay, not.
The portableness. I think the battery life is borderline a joke. It's almost impractical. Like,
so it's battery life is 2.5 to 6 hours.
Yeah, they're saying around 2.5 hours is what you could run something like Zelda.
They said 3 hours for Zelda.
Yeah, I don't believe
two
it.
Two and a half. But I have to imagine this is going to, like the 3DS, it's going to have a power save mode where it runs a little bit, you know, better, the brightness is down, something to help the battery.
I'm sure. It's just, yeah, it's... One thing that really frustrates me with, you know, the dream of this console in a lot of ways is home console on the go. That, I mean, that's the marketing, that's the push, and you can kind
of... It's not, though. Like, it is and it isn't. They're really getting mixed in there, and they need to figure out, I think, what it is. The original
commercial that everybody has seen. Yeah, not everybody's seen this presentation. Everybody saw that.
Well, because you've got, like, this, and I'm talking about the voice chat, like, oh, you're on the go, you don't want to bring it out, but then at the same time, they don't want to kill their 3DS.
They literally have a game that basically requires you to play it on the go at launch, 1-2 Switch.
Sure.
Outside in your backyard at parties and whatever. Yeah. Bring it to...
Karen's bringing it over.
To the schoolyard. Yeah. But... What I was going to say is part of my dream for like a truly unified Nintendo where it is a portable and it is a console is stop making 3DS games. Just
that's
stop.
The weird thing.
Have those developers just stop doing that.
Move it
make
all.
Make those 50, 60, what is there, 60-something million 3DSs right now? It's a lot. Like
it's high.
Make them all move.
Yeah.
It had a nice run.
Put a Fire Emblem Direct out today, and there is a new Fire Emblem game coming out in May. Why is that coming out on the 3DS? It needs to be coming out on the Switch.
It makes no sense.
That's another one that wasn't on the list. There's a Hyrule, a Fire Emblem Warriors game coming out sometime this year.
Not interested.
I know you're not interested, but there are...
Like, that's what should be happening. All those people that develop the really good 3DS games should only be focusing on developing really good Switch games. And the people who develop good Wii U games should only be focusing on... Like, everything should be about the Switch now because it does it all.
Sure.
I agree. I don't know what they're doing.
I agree with that. They're marketing right now. Their messaging seems mixed. And they need to figure it out. They need to just kill the 3DS.
And what happened, the last time that they had mixed, unclear messaging... It was when people didn't even understand the Wii U was a system.
Yep. That was the other thing. There's not going to be Street Pass or Miiverse on the Switch, which I imagine is because they're going to wait to kill the 3DS. Well, they'll probably wait until the 3DS dies to move it over. Because I feel like Street Pass would work so well on a Switch.
I think it would and it wouldn't because this thing will not fit in your pocket.
Yeah, but like it fits in your bag.
Yeah, I know.
If you're carrying it on the go.
Oh, one other thing I wanted to bring up. I'm worried. What are they called? Joy-Cons. Yeah, I'm worried about how those are going to really feel.
Yeah, that's...
One of the great things about a lot of Nintendo controllers is just, especially the WaveBird, is just how good they feel.
Mm-hmm.
And the gamepad never really did, but...
Well, the gamepad, like, felt cheap.
Yeah.
All the reports I've heard coming out of the event is like, this feels like a nice piece of tech.
Well, that's good because it has a lot in it, so I would hope that it would. And they're damn expensive.
Yeah.
But like, they just look so small. Everything about this looks so small. Like those games look so small.
Big hands.
I tweeted the picture like these. Well, nobody will ever lose one of those games because jokingly.
Oh yeah, they're.
But like those.
They're smaller than.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. You have like.
So like, I'm worried about how that's gonna fit. Like trying to play 2-player with 2 Joy-Cons.
Yeah, I don't think anyone will ever do that.
Like kids will,
sure,
but I won't probably. No. I'm spending enough.
I'm gonna spend 3 weeks of pay on a pro controller and use that to play Breath of the Wild and.
But see, I would play Breath of the Wild on with the Joy-Con grip, like that turns into a controller.
Maybe
that's a little sad dog face.
I wanna feel how that feels together.
Yeah,
I'll bring it. I think it looks dumb. I might have one.
Maybe not on launch day, though.
I don't know. I mean, I would assume it would be sent to my house. We'll see. We'll see. Sure. It's all...
But see, I think that's the one... And I know we're running a little long on time. I think that's the one advantage this console does have. Is, let's take, for example, PSVR. Christian, friend of the show, he's been on a couple times. He has a PSVR, and we've been talking so long. Oh, you got to come over. You got to try it out. Because I eventually, somewhere down the line, would like to get one. Doesn't seem game-wise to be doing very well. I probably won't be getting one for a while. I'm glad I didn't get one at launch. But does...
Quick sidebar
about
the PSVR and talking about the Switch and how it could have like problems keeping in stock. The PSVR not being able to be in stock around the holidays has now made me, I probably will never get a PSVR.
Yeah.
Because I would have bought one. I guarantee you I would have bought one if I had been able to get one before the holidays. And now with the Switch coming out and being, you know,
yep,
a little bit more than I expected it to be, and the peripherals definitely being more than I expected it to be, like, I won't get one. Sony, you screwed the pooch.
Yeah. So, and it's like, oh, you got to come over. Yeah, I'll come. And I just, I have not found any time or opportunity to go over there and try it out. Mm-hmm. But with the Switch, you want to try it out? Well, you have to come over. Let's go grab a beer somewhere. I'll bring it up. I'll bring it out. We'll try them out. We'll test it out. Like, you can take this anywhere. It eliminates that factor. It's like, oh, you haven't tried it? Well, here, let's try it out. And it brings that, you know, and there's the joke of, oh, Karen coming to the party and whatever. But, like, it does have that factor social factor.
You'll be able to bring it, and I'll be able to be like, well, I don't want to play any of Zelda because I want to experience that on my own. Sure. What else you got? Nothing?
Oh, Bomberman. Okay. I got Bomberman. We'll play Bomberman.
Yeah.
We'll play 1-2 Switch. We'll see how many balls are in our controller. Grab those balls and...
Three?
I think he needs to go to a doctor.
That thing.
Milk that cow.
People will play that for 2 minutes.
But that's all they've shown on it. Who knows what else is on it?
Nintendo. They let me down again.
The conference is bad. I'm still excited about the Switch itself, though.
I'm just not excited about the Switch if there are so many reasons at launch that I feel like people are either going to not be able to get it or feel disappointed that they have it for a while.
Sure.
And it will feel like Wii U again. And then...
Let me put it this way.
This better have a long life.
I'm excited about the Switch for me.
Where's Kirby? Where's
Metroid? I'm worried about the Switch as a whole. Like, for the population to see how this takes the market. I think this does have the potential to not hit Wii numbers, but kind of be the next Wii.
It doesn't need to be the next
Wii. It doesn't need to be the next Wii, but I'm saying...
It needs to be the next 64. It needs to be the next GameCube, which undersold.
Yeah.
But it just needs to be something that when you look back on it, like even the Wii, which sold 96 million consoles, I look back at it and go, I'm never going to play that thing again.
Sure.
I want it to be something where I'm like, you know what, I'm going to play this thing forever. Mm-hmm. And I'm not saying it's not there. I'm excited about this console. I'm not excited about what they talked about.
Sure. That's fair.
And I'm let down about how they did it.
I think that's the biggest blow is the conference as a whole and kind of the way that it's been messaged. But it's Nintendo being Nintendo. Well, that's what we thought about the Nintendo Switch reveal and the information we have so far. What do you think about it? Are you getting it day one? Did you pre-order? Did you pre-order? Are you getting Zelda? What do you think of the launch lineup? I think it's fine. I got the two games I'm looking for. He's not so hot on it. Let us know in the comments below, or you can tweet at both of us. I'm on Twitter at Rich Belson.
I'm at Stonks. It's two games for, like, the rest of the year.
It's not two games.
Yes.
I've got Zelda and Bomberman. That's all I fucking need.
That's two games.
Not for the rest of the year.
Almost. Mario's going to get pushed, and Mario Kart will be fun, but you could play it right now.
Sure. Not with battle mode. So, again, you can tweet at us, find us on Facebook at facebook.com/overabeer, or right here on youtube.com/overabeer. But that'll wrap things up for today. So, until next time, switch up.